What's going on, guys? My name is Drew and welcome to my very first content on YouTube. Normally I can be found streaming on Twitch, but I've decided to have a go at recording my very first series on YouTube. This will be an FM20 save, and for the first team we're going to manage, it's going to be Borussia Mönchengladbach. They're a team I've enjoyed watching since the return of the Bundesliga following obviously the lockdown rules. So yeah, I'm excited to be managing them. I'm excited to get into this save. They've got a lot of good players from what I've seen so far. I think this is going to be a really good save. They're also a very successful club in Germany. I wasn't aware of this, but they've won the league 5 times. They've also won the UEFA Cup twice and the German Cup 3 times. Overall, they're ranked 61st in the UEFA club rankings. So yeah, they're obviously a successful team in Germany, and I'm looking forward to getting into this. Right, guys, let's have a look at the club vision then set out by the board. So in terms of the club culture, there's very much an emphasis on the youth side of things. They're expecting us to sign players under the age of 23. Sign players based in Germany as well. That's an interesting one. That's preferred. So we'll obviously have a look at that when we're making our transfers. Not sign players over the age of 28. Again, there's an emphasis on the youth. And obviously the last one is develop players using the club's youth system. So I could definitely get on board with the view to bring in a lot of youth players and develop the youth side of the club, because that's something I've done at other clubs as well on FM. Obviously looking to bring in those wonder kids, those hidden gems, to bolster the team and obviously make the team better for the future is something I always look to do. So happy to get on board with that. In terms of the 5-year plan ongoing, so work within the wage budget is required. That's not going to be a problem depending on what the wage budget is. End of this current season, they're expecting us to qualify for the European Cup. That's required. Preferred is to reach the quarterfinal as a minimum of the German Cup, and to reach the quarterfinal as a minimum of the Europa League. So that's going to be an interesting one. We'll have to see how we get on there in terms of what our group's going to be. End of next season, they're expecting us to qualify for the Champions League, and then going forward, become recognised as the best of the rest. So an interesting club vision. Obviously, a lot of the areas I can get on board with in terms of the youth system. We'll have to see how much money we've got to be able to see if we can work within our wage budget, etc. And obviously those challenges in terms of qualifying for the Europa Cup, getting to the quarterfinals of the Europa Cup again, or the Europa League, will be interesting to see how we get on with those. So guys, let's have a look at the finances then. So overall, we've got a balance of 45.2 million. That seems quite low for a German team. Apparently our financial status is rich though. Can't remember what other clubs look like in terms of their overall balance, the likes of Munich and Dortmund, etc. Obviously we're not at that level yet, but obviously the plan is we intend to be. In terms of the transfer budget though, we've only got 8.6 million to spend. Obviously it was mentioned in the club's vision that they want us to work within our wage budget. We are very close to our wage budget limit. We're currently spending 865,000. Our wage budget is 896,000. So in terms of bringing players in, that's going to be tough. Obviously we need to evaluate the squad, see what we've got currently, what we might be missing, and whether we do actually need to make any signings this season. In terms of selling players on, we only get 90% of the transfer revenue. So going forward, obviously if we can make some profit going forward, we might be able to increase that to 100% so that we get the full transfer revenue when we do make any sales. But yeah, it's going to be an interesting one. 8.6 million transfer budget to spend. So yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how we go forward with this transfer budget and what sort of business we can do. Possibly some loan signings if we do need any players, but we'll have a look at the squad and see what we need to do. Right guys, let's have a look at our squad then. So it's a decent sized team. Obviously there's a mixture of youth and experience, which is good to see. Looks like we've got the makings of a really good spine as well, which is normally what I look for when I manage any team in FM. Obviously our goalkeeper Jan Sommer, quality goalkeeper, important player, obviously in his prime years at the age of 30, 3.5-star rated, good player for most Bundesliga sides, all the attributes to be a decent goalkeeper, which he is. So looking forward to having him as our number one. Nico Alvedi's only 22, has the potential to be a leading right back in the future, currently rated at 3-star with the potential ability to be 4-star, can play in a couple of positions as well, centre back and right back. I think I've managed him before on FM and used him in both positions, but obviously his preferred is right back. But obviously, again, attributes look really decent for a player at the age of 22. Dennis Zakaria, another player that I've managed in another FM save. Again, current ability 3.5 stars, potential to be 4. Important player for us and can still improve. Potential to be a leading Bundesliga central midfielder in the future. Only 22, but looking at those stats, he looks phenomenal. So obviously need to make sure we keep him fit. And if we were to lose him, I'm not sure we'd have suitable backup in that position, because it would be hard to replace a player of that quality. Brielle Mbolo might be somebody that a lot of FM players recognise. He is normally dubbed a wonder kid. He is currently rated as 3-star, potential ability 4-star, only age 22. Regular player who can still improve. I think it says here, potential to be a leading Bundesliga striker in the future, currently rated as good. Again, stats-wise, looks phenomenal. Can play in a couple of positions, but more than likely we'll play him up front. So Marcus Thuram is somebody that's performing really well currently in the Bundesliga. Not somebody I've used before. I've heard a lot of good things about him from other FM players who have signed him. Be interesting to see how he gets on. Obviously, his stats aren't amazing. And actually, it says here he could improve by a slight amount in the future. So they don't rate him very highly here. But be interesting to see how he gets on. Again, he can play in a couple of positions. Prefers an inverted winger, but obviously can play up front as well. So we'll see how he gets on, how he progresses this season. So guys, that concludes our intro into the save. This essentially will be episode 0, with episode 1 being the start of the season. Our first live com, an overview obviously of pre-season as well, how we've got on in our friendlies, and a bit of an overview of the transfer market as well, and what business we've done, if any. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. Please make sure you like, comment and subscribe, and we'll see you again in episode 1. You